brought to you by the Every Dollar app. Start budgeting for free today. Sarah is in Charlotte, North Carolina. Hi, Sarah. Welcome to the Ramsey Show.
Hi. Thank you so much for having me. How are you?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
So I have a two-part question. The first part of my question is, at what baby step do I figure out if I get term life insurance? I'm a single mom to two daughters. And then the second part of that question is if it's worth it to me, just based on the fact that the other parent, my daughter's father and I are no longer together, and there's a history of domestic violence. So I don't necessarily trust what will be done with life insurance, and my parents don't live in the country. So I'm just wondering if that's a viable option for me and what baby step I would incorporate that to.
Okay. It's not a baby step. It's a now.
Sorry.
It does not go in a baby step. Okay. The life insurance is a purchase out of your budget immediately. What baby step do you put car gasoline in? Not a baby step. You put it in your budget. You need car gasoline to run your car. You need to take care of your children if something happens to you. And so life insurance is an immediate purchase for you. So who is going to take care of the children if you were to pass away?
Their father.
I thought he had domestic violence issues.
Yeah, he still has custody due to the fact that the domestic violence is against me and not my children.
Oh, that's encouraging. It was just you.
Yeah.
I feel so much better.
It was just me. Yeah.
That's sarcastic.
They did supervise visitation for 2 months, and then they deemed him fit. So in the event that I passed, unfortunately, they would go to him. And as someone who has filed bankruptcy twice, I don't trust what he will do with that money.
No, he doesn't get the money. He gets the kids.
Right.
Okay.
So there is... If I were to go and speak to someone, there is a way to...
You would have the beneficiary of your life insurance be a trust. And the trust would be managed by a trustee, which is someone you select that you trust with money and to do your wishes. And the trust would say something like, the children can have the income off of the investment. What do you make a year?
About $48,000.
Okay, so if you had a $500,000 policy and you instructed the trust to invest that in mutual funds and it made $50,000 a year, that would replace the income that you've created. You probably don't need that much because hypothetically, this guy's actually going to feed these children anyway. So, but, you know, let's just say that you did $48,000, okay? So $4,000 a month. If it made $4,000 a month, you could distribute that to him as child support, and he gets a monthly income from to take care of the children for the good of the children as long as he is taking care of the children. The money goes where the kids are. So if the kids get the state comes and takes them because he commits domestic violence on them, then the money would just be you would instruct the trust to keep the money and build it up for when they're an adult.
Okay. That makes sense.
But you don't give him $50,000 or $500,000.
Correct, yeah.
You give him monthly income to help feed the children because he's not capable of even managing his own money, so we need to send some money over there for food. What a disaster. This is not this is not fun for me. I don't love the idea of the kids going over there, and I really don't love the idea of the kids going over there with money, but I would rather them go over there with money than without money.
Yeah, it's not been a fun 4 years for sure.
Yeah.
So, like, if God forbid something were to happen,
how old are the children?
They're 5 and 7. They're pretty young.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's my concern. And my parents don't live in the United States, so I wouldn't be able to make them like a executor.
They don't have to be a U.S. citizen to be a trustee. They could be in charge of the money.
Okay.
They could be in charge of the money. Yeah, you could leave them as the trustee.
It could be someone who does not live in the country necessarily. That was my other concern was
doesn't matter.
They're not a U.S. citizen. Okay.
They don't have to be. Perfect. They're managing money on behalf of a trust, not on behalf of themselves. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if you go to mamabearlegalforms.com, you can get what's called a family trust form and get a will. And the will says that the money is going to, and then buy a life insurance policy from Xander Insurance and make the beneficiary of the life insurance, meaning where the money goes upon your death, the name of that trust, the Sarah Trust, I'll call it. Mm-hmm. Okay. And it's there, the big chunk of money, whether it's $300,000-$400,000 is about all it needs to be here, goes into that, and then instruct your parents to invest the money as the trustees and to disperse a certain amount of money per month to him as child support.
Okay.
And as, if he no that longer is managing the children, the trust no longer sends the money to him.
Okay.
So if he were to... Well, I guess this is hypothetical. We don't know. Okay. So, I mean, would your parents take the children if they could?
If they could, they would. Obviously, okay. Being from a different country, myself included, it's a bit trickier. I've entertained the idea of moving back home, but he would not allow it. But I think in a hypothetical where his back was in a corner, and they were, my parents would be willing to take them.
Yeah. So, I mean, I want to stipulate a bunch of things there that as long as they end, if they end up taking care of the children, because the state takes the kids from him at some point, then they would also be receiving the money from this trust. I want to make sure these kids are taken care of. That's all we're doing here. Okay. So the purpose of life insurance is to replace the care through money that you give your family. And so if a guy's making, you know, $100,000 a year and his family is eating out of that, he needs $1 million in life insurance because $1 million invested at making 10% would be $100,000 a year. We've replaced that guy if he dies. We replace the income that he's creating. We replace the guy, but we replace the income that he's creating that sets him up to be able to win. Or sets the kids to be able, the family that's remaining up to be able to win financially and not make more money than they would have made with him here, but at least replace what he was doing. In your case, Sarah, what she was doing, replace what you're doing to care for these children income-wise, because your ex is obviously not responsible enough to send you money over there, so you're taking care of these kids. He's not responsible enough with money. He's not responsible enough with his own emotions. This is just not a good guy. There's nothing in this story that sounded exciting to me for him. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sorry you're facing all that. But Mama Bear Legal Forms, get your will and trust in place. Xander Insurance, get $300,000-$400,000 in life insurance. It's not very expensive. It's about the cost of a pizza. And you can make that fit in your budget, especially as you get out of debt and start to have more and more margin. So God bless you, honey. Sorry what y'all have been through over there. Open phones here at 888-825-5225. Some of the most courageous people in the world are those that are the other side of a domestic violence situation. And I'm an old redneck hillbilly. I don't even like the phrase domestic violence. It makes something extremely horrible and rage-inducing sound very lame. It's not lame at all. It changes family trees. It changes a tree. It puts a curse on a family that is unbelievable, that can only be broken by the power of God. I mean, it is a nasty mess when somebody's engaging in that stuff. And sadly, in the world we're in, we get to see it fairly often. And it just still just I'm just an old redneck. It just pisses me off. It's that simple.